Welcome to day kita ada Encik Hisham. Encik Hisham, please introduce yourself.
Okay, Assalamualaikum. Saya Hisham. EP untuk projek Atlas Sofia untuk Radius One.
Okay, so that is your position dalam projek ni?
Yes.
Okay.
Kalau ni
romantik
tak ni?
Ha, ini okey juga, dia sepia-sepia sikit. Kenapa dia tutupnya lampu? Okay, anyway. Okay, Abang Syam, you have been involving and then you banyak kali duduk kat set and you have seen the characters and you know the play. Basically, Abang Syam dia kita producer, jadi dia boleh tengok Russia sampai tengok preview dulu sebelum pergi ke channel, sebelum pergi ke mana-mana. Alright? So, Abang Syam, which one is your favourite character?
My favorite character,
satu je.
I can say Susie.
Okay, Susie. Why?
Sebab I think we never expect a person. I mean, like this is another character yang kita tak congkil, basically like macam kenapa, how come she can dia boleh sampai ke tahap itu. So maksudnya daripada kawan jadi daripada BFF, jadi benda lain, lepas tu sampai ke tahap yang lebih lain yang banyak kepada salah ke aku buat benda ni sebab aku nak ini, aku nak as I deserve to be happy. So things like that yang maybe public tak akan nak explore, maybe tak public akan nampak benda tu macam benda ni salah lah, tapi tak salah kepada orang yang mungkin untuk mendapat kebahagiaan, mencari kebahagiaan.
If not Jasmine Suraya yang bawa karakter Suzy, who you think best? Or pelakon yang you nak tengok dia bawa watak Suzy?
I strongly actually I recommended this particular cast, tapi sebab dia tak free and mungkin rezeki balik kepada Suzy.
At the end of the day,
Jasmine lah yang dapat anyway. So for me personally, I love Mimi Lana to be Suzy. This character, so at least maybe orang dah nampak Mimi dekat dalam beberapa cerita yang macam yang karakter yang macam ni, tapi mungkin mainan tu lain sebab Abang Izzat dia ada another magic that they can bring you out to something yang macam orang yang biasa nampak, tapi dia karakter tu dah biasa tapi dia ambil go deeper by like as far as the dialogue and the body language, semua dia compliment at one time. So benda macam tu yang mungkin I'm looking forward to see Mimi Lana yang macam tu.
So you've been over to the set many times and you know seen some few scenes.
Yeah.
Which one is your favourite scene?
Okay, favourite scene maybe benda ni tak keluar lagi, but what I love is the moments between these two party yang di meeting Phil dengan Sophia, the tone down or maybe dia orang buang ego masing-masing kat luar bilik, kat luar pintu tu, and they just want to compromise the sincerity of each other. So maksudnya macam okay, kau buat salah, aku buat salah. Ego tu selalunya dalam relationship, ego tu yang kau salah, kau kena minta maaf dengan aku. Aku salah, you know, things like that. Or maybe as a husband, always put that level like, aku ni suami, kau kena respect aku lah. So typical Malay punya. Tapi in this particular moment, which is when the cast like macam you tone down your ego, and as well as Sophia, Amir Hafiza, yang compromise is just because of sentiment love tu. Macam love tu actually dia mungkin jadi mangsa, tapi sebenarnya love tu juga yang boleh memperbaiki keadaan tersebut. So that is the magic moment that I believe benda ni pernah Abang Izzat ada buat dulu untuk tapi different perspective lah, things like that. Tapi I think dekat dalam ni juga, which is relationship of both party, antara husband and wife, di luar sana yang perlu ambil kira benda ni, ambil benda sebagai tiba untuk kita. By end of the day, everybody want to be happy.
Yep.
So like macam ego tu tak ke mana. Memang betul ego tu untuk emphasize what is that I don't like, what is you don't like, dislike dan semacam-macam. Tapi bila kita compromise isu tersebut, by end of the day we'll be happy. So that is the magic moment that I love to, and I want the public to even explore. Kalau boleh practice, why not? That will be even better.
Yeah. That is the message.
That is the message.
then kita try to, you know, slate in between subtly, subliminally. Alright, okay. If Under Sophia is a good series, why? If not, why?
Okay, kalau okay, one thing about Abang Izzat, basically, benda yang negatif pun kita boleh ambil benda tu dari sudut yang positif. Kalau you nampak, that is the angle that he's looking at. Contoh dia macam dalam cerita ni, kat sini dah keluar ke dah, you dah di penagih, dah orang datang ke belum?
Tak.
So contoh dia, perspektif seorang penagih itself yang perlu kita ambil, ambil kira dari segi like you like it's not a normal drug addict, you know, like people in the public tahu kalau drug addict orang ambil yang menampak typical, but they, you are not like that. So this is another how should I say, eye opener to people yang maybe is your close friend and you tak tahu dia penagih take directly, kan? So kita tak tahu, so which is good to educate the public kalau mereka nampak dari segi positive. So macam like you, when you bring on your character as a drug addict something like that, tapi you tunjukkan kepada orang ramai benda ni berlaku, korang jangan ambil benda tu mudah, tapi jangan ambil benda tu macam relax lah, tak apa, kita tak ada apa-apa, tapi efek dia ada banyak akan berlaku dan everything. So when people, the audience tengok cerita tu, then you boleh tengok development of fear dari awal macam mana gitu tersebut. So that is the education learn yang kita ni personally love to explore together with the public untuk tengok, rather than you hentam apa cerita pikir tak. So that is the beauty of Adila Sofia lah.
Yep.
Itu kalau dari segi sudut positif. Kalau you kata dari sudut negatifnya, the making lah. So we are constantly macam my AD nangis. Cuba tunjuk sikit AD you kat sana.
EP menangis, menangis.
So AD,
EP pun menangis juga.
EP menangis lah.
Dah ini video dia, dia taklah cakap dia menangis.
Menangis, but budget burst dengan ni ha, kita punya dan punya dia salah seorang daripada penyumbang untuk yang membuatkan aku menangis lah. But end of the day, I love the magic of everyone to contribute and giving the best as they can to make this movie, this series a success. Cuma kita tak adalah nak sangat benda tu macam happening ke apa ke. Maksudnya everybody, niat kita bila kita buat projek tu sincerely. So terpulanglah dekat anda di luar tu untuk judge. Kalau tak suka, itu anda berhak untuk tidak suka. Kalau anda suka, alhamdulillah. Tapi kami di sini bukan untuk buat yang you suka. Indirectly, kita nak tunjuk reality and what is
something
happening in the society.
You might like.
You might think of this might be another difference. Itulah magic and I really respect and who's this? You personally to involve this project. I can see a color of you, your acting here daripada yang kita I tak pernah explore and how dedicated you are. So you also contribute in like in writings together to make this series a success. So thanks to you also.
Welcome. Bantu. Please, I will send you the invoice.
I'm about to say that. I dah cover dah. I dah cakap thank you very much. Dengan harapan
tak ada invoice.
Tak ada invoice tu. Tapi I rasa tidak tu. Sebab
I'm also very good at writing invoices.
Yeah.
Okay. Any last word for the audience? Short one.
Terima kasih kerana
bersama-sama
the journey of Adila Sofia. So kalau yang salah ke apa ke, kami minta maaf. Saya personally meminta maaf, but we are humans. To us, kita tunjukkan yang tak bagus tu adalah untuk tatapan masyarakat supaya menjadi iktibar. Tapi kalau you influenced by that, it's your choice, but end of the day, it's not as simple as that.
It's your choice. Cium sikit.